Howdy, y'all. May 25th. We back here. Looks like somebody worked on the baler. Somebody moved it since yesterday when I was running around with Dad and all that stuff. So, you can't see it, but I'm assuming a neighbor come over and flipped the belts for us. These two are incredibly loose. The rest of these are all tight. No. Incredibly loose. Those two are incredibly loose. Anyways, he fixed the tire too and brought it back, put it on. Looks like. And boy was shopping today. I passed him on the road with his big old self-propelled chopper doing some custom harvesting. Well, that might be ready to go back to work for 5 minutes right now. But today, Dad's got this tractor and a wagon, and we're gonna load some hay bales out the field back here. So I'm gonna hook the 40-20 to the gooseneck and get doing something. My bales out here, we gotta get them before the cows destroy them all. My dainty bales are not as tough as the one with the net wrap on. Thank you. Well, y'all, normally we get about we get about 12 on there, but he's got quite a few there, about 20 of them on there.
Yeah, he could have got one more on there if he just stacked the one in the back right. We're only going quarter mile. It'll work, hopefully. I mean, I've had them fall off for less effort, so.
We got plenty of time, so we're just gonna take a slow ride over to the haystack, and then we'll unhook his trailer, and he can unload it in his time frame tomorrow. If not tonight. Normally do stuff like this, but these are little bales and he's having fun. By the fence, he said. He's gonna go ahead and feed all these up first, since they have string on them instead of net wrap. Which is understandable. Put some of his bales on the bottom there. The ones on the bottom there would be the normal size bales that we normally make out of the 664. They're about a 5x5 bale. I was really worried that they were gonna fall off because this one side over here was leaning pretty good. That little tractor right there has been the greatest tractor ever. I know y'all have heard me say that before, but it's still the greatest tractor ever. 4610, number 2, 1990 model. It's been the greatest tractor ever. This one over here is okay, but it has issues sometimes. Bought that one off the neighbor because they had one they wanted to sell, and I don't know, Dad just for nostalgic purposes figured he should have one like the neighbors have. So, you know, it's getting smaller. Got everything in three loads. If it doesn't fall off. Well, actually, there's one more. We'll get it done. He did rake all that out there in the field today. So maybe he'll rig it again tomorrow. We'll see what happens. Maybe we'll fail it. Well, I did lose one. It's all good. It ain't in the road. I'm going home. I hope you enjoyed our stupidness. We don't usually do that. But those are little tiny bales, and we literally have a half mile to go. So, anyways, y'all like, subscribe, and catch you later.